the world.
Thank the Lord for another opportunity to come your way with the precious word of God concerning prayer. And you know, last time I spoke, we was talking about, we were looking at Hebrews 4:16, but first let's have a word of prayer and then we go on from there. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank the Lord that we have this great opportunity that we can come to the throne of grace bold and find help and mercy in a time of need. Lord, what a privilege we have that we can pray, that we can talk to you, that we can cast all our cares on you, Lord, because we belong to you. Those that have accepted you as their Lord and personal Savior, Lord, you seek us as your children. So we thank you that we can come and according to your will, we can cast it all on you. In Jesus' name I pray, amen. Well, last time I spoke to St. Will talking about Hebrews 4:16, and I'll read that. And like I said, we're definitely looking at the first part of that verse, but I'll read the whole verse to give you an idea of what the verse says. Verse 16 says, let us therefore come with assurance and confidence unto the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace to help in the time of need. And the last time we looked at how we can come boldly, and that we cannot come any old kind of way to the Lord. We're to come with a spirit of humility, with our heart clean, with our motives pure, and then we can come in boldly. Boldly, that denotes confidence, and coming with confidence. And it's because of what Christ has accomplished for us. The throne of grace. He is our great high priest. And thank the Lord that we can come because he's sitting at the right hand of God interceding for us. So last time we just looked at that first part. Let us come boldly unto the throne of grace. Today we're going to look at, we're going to talk about the throne of grace, that we may obtain mercy and find grace. That we may obtain mercy and find grace. Late time I'll be to help in that time of need. We'll be looking at that next time. But mercy, when we think about mercy, mercy is that God does not give us what we do deserve. Or we might say unmerited favor. That's what mercy is. And thank God, you know, for his mercy. And then grace means that he gives us what we do not deserve. Or God, maybe sometimes we say it's God's righteousness at Christ's expense. So we won't look at that. And in the 117th Psalm, we're just talking about mercy today. We'll look at a few scriptures along that line. Look at in Psalm 103:17. We want to look at that. Psalm 103:17. And it said, but the mercy of the Lord is from everlasting upon them that fear him, and his righteousness unto children's children. So we see now that mercy is everlasting. It's from all, it goes to all generations. Those who come to God with reverential fear and obedience and do his will overcome the sharpness of physical life. And he gives us eternal life. That's his mercy. His mercy gives us life, eternal life. And we, in the scriptures, we said that those who come to God with reverence and fear and obedience to do his will overcome the shortness of physical life. This physical life don't last for so long. But God's mercy gives us eternal life. And that's eternal. What is eternal? That means it's forever. It's ever. His mercy is everlasting. Everlasting. And we want to look at a scripture concerning that to bring that point out. Let's look at Luke 1:50 a minute. And you can see that where that brings that out at. Luke 1:50. In the New Testament, we're talking about Luke 1:50. It sort of brings that out a little bit. That's the scripture to, that authenticates that. Luke 1:50. And 150 says, and his mercy is on them that fear him from generation to generations. It's boundless. It has no bound. It's from generation to generation. It's everlasting. His mercy from generation to generation, it says in Luke 1:50. And we need to thank the Lord for that. That his mercy is from generation and generation. And when we accept him as our Lord and personal Savior and come to him with a spirit of reverential fear and obedience to his will, he gives us, we will overcome the shortness of this physical life. Now, this physical life only lasts you but a few years, you know. But eternal life, it lasts forever. And his mercy gives us that eternal life. We saw that in Luke 1:50. And not only is his mercy eternal, it is also boundless. Boundless. That means it reaches every area of life, every area of existence. It reaches above the heavens. And his truth reaches unto the clouds. And that's it. Talk about his mercy. It's everlasting, and it reaches above heaven and unto the cloud. And we cannot see further than the heavens, we know that, or the clouds. And whatsoever we see of God's mercy and truth, there is still more to be seen. Thank God, and one day we will see that when we go into his kingdom. We will see that. It's still more to be seen and reserved to be seen in the world to come. Thank God, amen. It says, I think the scripture says, eyes have not seen and ears have not heard what the Lord has prepared for them that love him, to them that fear him, to them that hearts are right and motives are pure. Our eyes have even seen. And still talking about his mercy. Not only does it is mercy boundless, it reaches all areas of life, it reaches to every area, to every generation. But his mercy also prolongs life. It prolongs life. What a blessing that is. It prolongs life. When we accept Jesus as our Lord and personal Savior, he gives us eternal life. Ain't that a blessing? Thank God, once we accept him as our Lord and personal Savior, he gives us eternal life, a life forever with him. You know, in Lamentation, it brings that out a little bit. In Lamentation chapter 3, verse 22, we often read that scripture sometimes in Lamentation 3:22. I read that scripture. It said, it is of the Lord's mercy that we are not consumed because his compassions, his love, and his mercy, it fails not. It fails not. It's everlasting. It's from eternity to eternity. It fails not. Talking about his mercy. That's why we can go through the throne of grace and go with boldness and confidence and to be assured that he will hear whatever we cast on him. But our hearts have to be right and our motives have to be pure. God's steadfast love never ceases and his mercy never comes to an end. And when we come to him with clean and pure hearts, he willingly responds with steadfast love and mercy. What a blessing. What a blessing. We have that privilege that we can come to the throne of grace and find mercy and grace to help in time of need. And we can say, Lord, I thank you. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your grace. And sometimes, you know, even when our hearts are unclean and are not pure, our motives are not pure, we can still come to him with a repentant spirit. Say, Lord, forgive me of all my sins and iniquity. And he promised to forgive us. That's another blessing, amen. I mean, you're a child of God. That don't mean you're not going to sin anymore, but God knows our heart, you know. And we can come to him with a spirit of repentance and still can come born. And he promised us forgiveness. And that's why we can be assured. That's why we can be confidence that we would answer when we come with a repentant heart, with a heart of humility. Because sometimes we don't even know we may sin, you know, by sin of omission or commission, you know, when we come to God, but we can repent and say, Lord, forgive me. And he's able to intercede for us. The scripture says, for we know not what to pray about, but we still can come boldly. For his love and mercy is greater than any sin. That's what I like. It's greater than any sin. His love and mercy is greater than any sin. And you can see it when we look at that scripture in 1 John 3:20, it says, let me turn to that a minute. 1 John 3:20. We often, some of these scriptures now we have read, but it's always good to go back and refresh our minds on those things, those scriptures. And the Holy Spirit can bring those scriptures back to our mind that can give us assurance and courage. 1 John 3:10 and 4, it says, if our heart condemn us, and a lot of times our heart do condemn us, doesn't it? Sure it does. But God is greater than our heart. Ain't that a blessing? You know, our heart may condemn us, but God is greater than our hearts, because he knows our hearts, and he knows all things. Not some things, but he knows all things. What a Savior, and what a blessing that is, that we can come boldly to the throne and have this confidence that we can cast all our cares on him. Not only our own cares and own situation and family situation, but the cares of this world. We can cast them on him when our hearts are pure. Because we're his children. He loves us. He died for us. And he gave us the great privilege to talk to him about everything. We can tell him about everything. After we call him our Father, we can tell him our Father. We can call on him that way. He said, Father, I blew it. And he'll say, and we can ask him for forgiveness. He'll say, I forgive you. And that's a true blessing, isn't that right? It's a true blessing. His mercy forgives all our sins, it says. We can look at a scripture along that line. His mercy forgives all our sins. In Micah 7:18, turn to that a minute. In the minor prophet in Micah, we want to look at. I know sometimes when we look at these Old Testament minor prophet. We had to go back to the books of the Bible then, Lord, where's that book? You know, we might say that sometimes. But we, you know, if you've been in the mission long enough, you know, we're always missing the books of the Bible. So we turn to Michael. And we'll look at verse 7-18. The book of Michael. It's a minor prophet. And when you And the quicker way to find it, when you find Obadiah, if you step out the door, you walk right into Micah. Micah 7:18, for his mercy forgives sin, and Micah 7:18. What a scripture it is in Micah 7:18. Here you find that Micah praises God for his mercy, and he asks a question. It's a question to ask, and who is a God like unto thee? I mean, sometimes we may ponder that ourselves. Who is a God like unto our God? That pardoneth, look at it, that pardoneth iniquity or sin, and passes by the transgression of the remnant of his heritage. Who is that God? That's Jesus. That's Jesus. God loves. He loves to be merciful to us. He does not forgive grudgingly. Ain't that something? No, he doesn't forgive brotherly, but is glad when we repent. You don't thought about that, did you? He's glad when we repent. He wants us to repent and offer forgiveness to all who come to him, talking about his children. That's verse 18. Now look at verse 19, what it said. Well, let's finish verse 18. I'll read it again. Who is God like unto thee that pardons his iniquity and passes by transgressions of the remnant of his heritage? He retaineth not his anger forever, because he delighteth in his mercy. Verse 19 says, he will turn again, he will have compassion upon us, and that he's a God of compassion. He will subdue our iniquities, and thou will cast all thy sins into the depth of the sea. Ain't that something? The scripture says he will remember our sins no more. He cast them as far as the east is from the west. Ain't that something? What a savior. That's what Micah is saying. Who is this God? Who is this God that does that? He's talking about Jesus. Talking about him. Verse 20 says, thou wilt perform the truth to Jacob and the mercy to Abraham, when thou hast sworn unto our father from the days of old. What a savior. What a privilege that we can come boldly and find mercy and grace. We'll talk about this next time in the time of deeds. And we thank him. When we meditate on that scripture and go back now to Hebrews 4:16, when we meditate on that scripture and see what we have, when we come to the Lord with pure heart, we say, Lord, I thank you. Thank you, Lord, that I can come boldly. Thank you, Lord, that I can come with a reverential type fear. That I can come and cast all my cares on you, and that your mercy and grace can pardon all my iniquities. And that I can, next time we'll talk about, I can find that grace to help in the time of needs. We'll talk about the next time. Grace to help in the time of needs. And as Michael said, who is this God? Who is this God that cast all our cares and sins into the depths of the sea? What a blessing. So we're going to stop there, Satan. We just thank you, Lord, for this great opportunity that we have, that we can pray. Prayer is talking to God, talking to the Lord. It's fellowship and communion with him. Casting all our cares, all our discouragement, all our other things on him. Casting all our sins on him. What a blessing that is, that we have that. And we can be encouraged to continue to pray for all things. And maybe you're listening to this message today, and God still, his mercy and grace is open to all. And if you have never accepted him as your Lord and personal Savior, his mercy and grace can save you and can bond you into the family. But all you have to do is come, you see. Come, he says. Come unto me and cast all your cares upon me, for I care for you. If you know, ask the Lord to come into your heart and life and to save you and to born you into his family. This would be a great time to do that as you listen to this message. You can talk to him and say, Lord, I'm a sinner. And I ask you, Lord, to come into my heart and life and to save me, and to born me into your family, that I can have that boldness to come to the throne of grace anytime, every time, and all the time. And he will welcome me to do it But first you have to be saved. That you ask him to come into your heart and life and to save you. Then thank him. Say, Lord, you know, I thank you for saving me. Then, Lord, help me, Lord, to be not ashamed of your words, that you can help me to grow in your grace and in the knowledge of thee. He'll do it. He's the greatest heart surgeon I've ever known. And he can change a person's heart and mind in an instant once they repent and come to him and be born into his family. And just thank him for that. If you pray that prayer, the Lord can save you instantly. He don't have to wait around to save you. He saves you instantly as you come to him in repentance and let him know that you want to be born again. And say, we're going to stop there. Let us have a word of prayer as we conclude this message on prayer. Father, in the name of Jesus, oh Lord, what a Savior. Thank you, Lord, that we can come boldly unto the throne of grace. Lord, that we might obtain mercy, that we might receive mercy and find grace to help in a time of need. And Lord, oh, how we need you. We need you every moment, every minute, every hour of the day. And thank you, Lord, you're there. And you are braided not. You don't scold us when we come. Your word said, Lord, you're glad when we come to cast all our care on you and repent. So we thank you for, Lord, that we may meditate on the scriptures, how we can come boldly in prayer unto the throne of grace. And Lord, you will give us mercy and you will give us that mercy we need to find grace to help in a time of need. And we need you, Lord. We need you more and more as the day goes on, as the time goes on, Lord. We need you more and more this day. But thank you that you're there and you're able to undertake on every hand. Undertake for all the saints, Lord, that they might continue to stand and stand on your word. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen.